Hi friends, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for Current Affairs. I welcome you all in this series of Morning Tales that is for phase 1 of banking exams like RBI, SEBI, NABARD or other banking exams at the level of PU. So let's begin this video without wasting any time. But again, I would say this thing, the students who are coming for the first time, they should subscribe to our channel and hit this bell notification so that whenever we upload new videos, you get the instant updates. Also guys, if you have any kind of query related to your preparation of exams, then you can join this Telegram group where we provide the free quizzes as well as share the queries of students. So the link of this group is in description box below from where you can join the So here is our first question. Which state has received the crawler software from Interpol to track the child pornography material uploaded online? So basically this crawler software has been given by Interpol, and this software I must say is very quick and is very dexterous in tracking the child pornography material being circulated online. And because of that, this crawler software has been given to a state in India. Which state it is? It is Maharashtra. So Maharashtra state has got this crawler software to track the child pornographic material that is being circulated online. So in order to train its personnel in this crawler software, a team of 12 cyber officials, or we can say cyber police officials, have been sent to Interpol's South Asian unit for training. Now guys, what is so important about this thing? The important thing here is that these 12 people constitutes TRACE unit. So the TRACE is an acronym for the full form. The full form is Tactical Response Against Cyber Child Exploitation. And this is the TRACE unit which will train the other police officials in this crawler software, how to use this crawler software. Now apart from this Maharashtra police has also launched an Operation Blackface. Now this Operation Blackface has not been launched recently, it was launched earlier, but since we are talking about child pornography, therefore we should also know about this Operation Blackface. We cannot leave it behind. So this Operation Blackface was launched by Maharashtra police in order to curb the child sexual abuse material from being disseminated. So basically in order to reduce the spread of the child sexual abuse material or pornographic material, this Operation Blackface was launched by Maharashtra government. And now in the month of December, the Maharashtra government has obtained this crawler software from Interpol. Now, Interpol is the world's biggest police organization, which is located in Lyon, France. Remember this thing. Now, guys, can you tell me that how many countries are a member of this Interpol? So, this is your question for the day. Do tell it in the comment section below. So this is the question number 2. What is the new height of Mount Everest? So you must have come across the whole news of this Mount Everest height being elevated. So I have put up this question from that news only. Recently, the China and Nepal governments have announced that the total height of Mount Everest has increased. So the total height is at present is 29,031 feet, which is 8.86 meters. So the additional is this 0.86 meters. Earlier, before this discovery, only 8.848 meters was the height of Mount Everest. Now it has been elevated by this 0.86 meters. Why is it important? The reason behind this is this Mount Everest is the world's highest peak. Therefore, a question might come up from the examination from here only. So remember this thing that China and Nepal are the two countries that have collaboratively announced the new height of Mount Everest. And what is the new height? It is this in feet and this in meters. So that's all for this question. Now we are moving ahead with our third question, which is very important. So what is the GDP growth rate for FY21 for the world by Fitch Ratings? So recently this Fitch Ratings has released its global economic outlook report. And you must be aware of this fact that these kinds of organizations release such reports periodically, or we can say very frequently. Therefore, I usually say this thing, or I repeatedly say this thing, that you should remember the latest forecast only. So here we are talking about the latest forecast given by Fitch Ratings for the world as well as India. So first let's discuss about the world's forecast, then we will be moving ahead towards the Indian forecast. So for the world, for FY21, it is -3.7. Guys, this is an elevation from the previous forecast, and you are not required to remember the previous forecast, just remember the latest forecast, that it is -3.7%, and this is an elevation from the previous forecast. The reason behind that is the unlocking that is going on around the world. Now, as I told you that we will be discussing about India's GDP projections as well as world GDP projections of the upcoming years. So for FY22, that is 2021 to 22, the projected GDP growth rate is 5.3%, and for FY23 it is 4% for the world. So it is the global GDP projection given by Fitch Ratings. Now for India, FY21 growth rate is -9.4%. Earlier it was 10.5%. -10.5%. So clearly it is being shown here that the projection has been uplifted, the projection has been improved for India. Why is this so? The reason behind is the quarter second growth. So in Q2, that is second quarter of this year, India has contracted by 7.5% as compared to the Q1 growth rate, which was 23.9%, -23.9%. So this is being seen as a great improvement in India's GDP growth rate, and therefore this number is quite is in news. So therefore you have to remember that in quarter 2 of this year the GDP contraction was -7.5%. Now we have discussed this year's projection for India. For FY22 it is +11%, and for FY23 it is 6.3%. So these are the projections that you have to remember. So our next question is, who has become the first ever Indian origin speaker of one of the Canadian assembly, that is British Columbia Legislative Assembly? So clearly the significance of this question is in this phrase only, that is the first ever Indian origin speaker of this Canadian assembly. Now who is that person? It is Raj Chauhan. So he is the first ever Indian who has become the speaker of one of the Canadian assembly. Now guys, your task is to tell me the Prime Minister of Canada. So this is your question. I hope that you will answer all the questions in the comment section below. Which of the following dance form has been included as a sport in the 2024 Paris Olympics? Quite an interesting question, right? So a dance form has been included as a sport. So which form it is? It is break dancing. So break dancing has been included as a sport in 2024 Paris Olympics. Apart from this break dancing, these three S, surfing, skateboarding and sport climbing, these three sports have also been included in as the sports in 2024 Paris Olympics. And remember guys that these three sports are also going to be there in Tokyo Olympics 2021. So breakdancing is going to make its appearance in 2024 Paris Olympics, but these three sports will definitely be there in Tokyo Olympics 2021. Now guys, do you know what is the schedule or what are the venues of Olympics? So let's discuss that. So here in this table, you can see that all the Olympic Games schedule, or we can say the venues as well as the years, are mentioned. So if you want, you can take a screenshot of the screen so that you can remember the upcoming tournaments, Olympics, and their venues. In 2024, it is the Summer Olympics, and in 2028, it is going to be held in Los Angeles, US. 2022, Winter Olympics in Beijing. 2026 in Milano Cortina, Italy. Youth Olympics in 2020, Lausanne, Switzerland. 2026 in Dakar, Senegal. So this was to be held in 2022, but now it has been postponed till 2026. So remember the venues as well as the years of these Olympic tournaments that are going to be held in soon. Now comes our next question. Where is the Ashfaq Ullah Khan Prani Udyan located? So this is a static question. Where it is located? It is located in Uttar Pradesh. Now why is it in news? The reason behind this is that this Ashfaq Ullah Khan Prani Udyan, as well as Rajgir, Zoo Safari. So these are the two zoos that have been given the official recognition by Central Zoo Authority, and therefore these two zoos are in news, and you have to remember that where are they located. So this is in Uttar Pradesh and this is in Bihar. Remember the places where these two are located. Apart from the locations, there is nothing to be remembered from this news. So now let's move on to the next question. What is the name of the program launched by MasterCard, National Institute for Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises, and the CII to support digitization of MSMEs? Clearly, the purpose of this program is mentioned here, that is to support the digitization of MSMEs. What is the name? The name is Saksham, which is going to target over 3 lakh MSMEs in India and support them in digitizing their operations. So that is all from this question, from this news. Apart from this, there were nothing much to be discussed from this news. So guys, this is the static question and the last question of the day. Where is Banerghat National Park located? So it is located in Karnataka, near Bangalore in Karnataka. So this is the last question of the day, and here the session ends. I hope that you have really enjoyed the session, and if you have, then do like this video and share it with your friends as well. Thank you so much for watching this video.